Chapter 20. And all the sons of Israel go out, and the company is assembled as one man, from Dan even unto Beersheba, and the land of Gilead unto Jehovah, at Mizpeh. And the chiefs of all the people, of all the tribes of Israel, station themselves in the assembly of the people of God, 400,000 footmen drawing sword. And the sons of Benjamin hear that the sons of Israel have gone up to Mizpeh, and the sons of Israel say, "Speak ye! How hath this evil been?" And the man, the Levite, husband of the woman who hath been murdered, answereth and saith, "Into Gibeah, which is to Benjamin, I have come, I and my concubine, to lodge. And rise against me do the masters of Gibeah, and they go round the house against me by night. Me they thought to slay, and my concubine they have humbled, and she dieth. And I lay hold on my concubine, and cut her in pieces, and send her into all the country of the inheritance of Israel. For they have done wickedness and folly in Israel. Lo, ye are all sons of Israel. Give for you a word and counsel here." And all the people rise as one man, saying, "None of us doth go to his tent, and none of us doth turn aside to his house. And now, this is the thing which we do to Gibeah, against it by lot. And we have taken 10 men of 100, of all the tribes of Israel, and 100 of 1,000, and 1,000 of a myriad, to receive provision for the people, to do at their coming to Gibeah of Benjamin, according to all the folly which it hath done in Israel." And every man of Israel is gathered unto the city as one man, companions. And the tribes of Israel send men among all the tribes of Benjamin, saying, "What is this evil which hath been among you? And now give up the men, sons of worthlessness, which are in Gibeah, and we put them to death, and we put away evil from Israel." And the sons of Benjamin have not been willing to hearken to the voice of their brethren, the sons of Israel. And the sons of Benjamin are gathered out of the cities to Gibeah, to go out to battle with the sons of Israel. And the sons of Benjamin number themselves on that day. Out of the cities are 26,000 men drawing sword, apart from the inhabitants of Gibeah, who numbered themselves 700 chosen men. Among all this people are 700 chosen men, bound of their right hand, each of these slinging with a stone at the hair, and he doth not err. And the men of Israel numbered themselves, apart from Benjamin, 400,000 men, drawing sword, each of these a man of war. And they rise and go up to Beth-El, and ask of God, and the sons of Israel say, "Who doth go up for us at the commencement to battle with the sons of Benjamin?" And Jehovah saith, "Judah, at the commencement." And the sons of Israel rise in the morning, and encamp against Gibeah, and the men of Israel go out to battle with Benjamin, and the men of Israel set themselves in array with them for battle against Gibeah. And the sons of Benjamin come out from Gibeah, and destroy in Israel on that day 22,000 men to the earth. And the people, the men of Israel, strengthen themselves, and add to set the battle in array in the place where they arranged themselves on the first day. And the sons of Israel go up and weep before Jehovah till the evening, and ask of Jehovah, saying, "Do I add to draw nigh to battle with the sons of Benjamin, my brother?" And Jehovah saith, "Go up against him." And the sons of Israel draw near unto the sons of Benjamin on the second day. And Benjamin cometh out to meet them from Gibeah on the second day, and destroy among the sons of Israel again 18,000 men to the earth. All these are drawing sword. And all the sons of Israel go up, even all the people, and come into Beth-El, and weep, and sit there before Jehovah, and fast on that day till the evening, and cause to ascend burnt offerings and peace offerings before Jehovah. And the sons of Israel ask of Jehovah, and there is the Ark of the Covenant of God in those days, and Phinehas, son of Eleazar, son of Aaron, is standing before it in those days, saying, "Do I add again to go out to battle with the sons of Benjamin, my brother, or do I cease?" And Jehovah saith, "Go up, for tomorrow I give him into thy hand." And Israel setteth liars in wait against Gibeah round about. And the sons of Israel go up against the sons of Benjamin on the third day, and arrange themselves against Gibeah as time by time. And the sons of Benjamin come out to meet the people. They have been drawn away out of the city, and begin to smite some of the people, wounded as time by time in the highways, of which one is going up to Beth-El, and the other to Gibeah in the field, are about 30 men of Israel. And the sons of Benjamin say, "They are smitten before us as at the beginning." But the sons of Israel said, Let us flee, and draw them away out of the city unto the highways. And all the men of Israel have risen from their place, and arranged themselves at Baal Tamar, and the ambush of Israel is coming forth out of its place, out of the meadow of Gibeah. And they come in over against Gibeah, 10,000 chosen men out of all Israel, and the battle is grievous, and they have not known that the evil is striking against them. And Jehovah smiteth Benjamin before Israel, and the sons of Israel destroy in Benjamin on that day 25,100 men. All these are drawing sword. And the sons of Benjamin see that they have been smitten, and the men of Israel give place to Benjamin, for they have trusted unto the ambush which they had set against Gibeah, and the ambush have hasted, and push against Gibeah, and the ambush draweth itself out, and smiteth the whole of the city by the mouth of the sword. And there was the appointed sign to the men of Israel with the ambush, their causing to go up a great volume of smoke from the city. And the men of Israel turn in battle, and Benjamin hath begun to smite the wounded among the men of Israel, about 30 men. For they said, Surely they are utterly smitten before us, as at the first battle. And the volume hath begun to go up from the city, a pillar of smoke. And Benjamin turneth behind, and lo, gone up hath the perfection of the city toward the heavens. And the men of Israel have turned, and the men of Benjamin are troubled, for they have seen that the evil hath stricken against them, and they turn before the men of Israel unto the way of the wilderness, and the battle hath followed them. And those who are from the city are destroying them in their midst. They have compassed the Benjamites, they have pursued them, with ease they have trodden them down till over against Gibeah at the sun rising. And there falleth Benjamin 18,000 men, the whole of these are men of valor. And they turn and flee toward the wilderness, unto the rock of Rimmon, and they glean of them in the highways 5,000 men, and follow after them unto Gidom, and smite of them 2,000 men. And all those falling of Benjamin are 25,000 men drawing sword on that day, the whole of these are men of valor. And there turn and flee into the wilderness unto the rock of Rimmon 600 men, and they dwell in the rock Rimmon 4 months. And the men of Israel have turned back unto the sons of Benjamin, and smite them by the mouth of the sword out of the city, men unto cattle, unto all that is found, also all the cities which are found, they have sent into fire.